director of Not Another Teen Movie.
Hi, I'm Jamie Presley, and I play the nasty cheerleader.
I'm Chris Evans, I played the popular jock.
Hi, I'm Kyler Lee, I play the ugly pretty girl.
What's up, it's Dion Richmond, the token black guy.
My name is Eric Youngman, and I play the obsessed best friend.
My name is Mia Kirshner, and I play the cruelest girl in school.
Eric Christian Olsen, I play the cocky blonde guy.
The concept of the movie is to make fun of all the teen movies that have come out in the last 10 years.
It's a parody of teen movies, both from the late 90s and from the 80s. And we sort of took a lot of characters and storylines and scenes that you may have remembered from some of these movies, and we sort of pulled them all up and mixed them all together and made a big mixed bag teen movie.
Well, they approached us to do an 80s cover for the film, Not Another Teen Movie. It's a fine line because it's a comedy and that's not really something that I do musically. So I thought Tainted Love would be interesting. I think it has a level of sarcasm to it, but it's not a novelty. It's not a joke.
We wanted to do a house party that was somewhat similar to that in the movie, with a certain exception of we added Marilyn Manson to the equation.
So I wanted to have like the regular party you'd probably see in a Britney Spears video, and insert sort of an exaggerated version of my crowd and my friends and things like that. So to make sort of a goth hip-hop, sort of a ghetto Dracula was kind of the term I was rolling with on this one.
Jamie, who's in the movie, this is her party. And Mia, one of the other co-stars, is bringing an uninvited guest who winds up being Marilyn Manson and a few of his friends to come show suburbia how they should really party. The goth kids kind of take over the party, kind of led by Manson.
I just wanted to play around with stuff that we see every day on MTV and turn that into my own thing. And also have naked girls and exploit them. First day making up the video. This fella is my assistant, John Thomas. His dad is actually the guy who hosted Who Wants to Marry a Millionaire.
Hi, Dad.
So what they're shooting right now is me entering the party, the kitchen, I guess, and people's reactions to it. Some dirty blonde trying to give me the eye. They're gonna get shot down because I'm bringing my strip dancing ghetto Dracula broads with me. It's hard for me to focus as a artist when this guy is just, I feel bad for him a little bit.
You need something, Manson?
Nothing but a goth thing, baby.
You ready?
Yeah. Here we go! Action! Once I ran to you,
a performance set with Manson, something he hasn't totally seen yet, so it's gonna be kind of cool, like, to show it to him and figure out what gear he's gonna get in, so stay tuned.
So I'm getting ready to do a performance of the day here at the gazebo.
And playback!
I think my favorite is in the gazebo, which was something that we just did at the last minute, and I'm sure it's going to turn out to be one of the main performance parts of the video. It has an element of the Hype Williams style of rap videos that we've seen a million times over, but it's twisted enough that it makes it interesting. It's not really a parody of that. It's just my own version of that, and I thought it came out looking, you know, better than I imagined.
And cut.
And cut. Very nice. So here we are at the pool. Very much a kissing setup scene.
Yeah.
With one exception. some of the goth kids that rolled into the party with Manson on their skateboards are gonna come in here and go for a little swim. So, and a couple doesn't know about it yet, so we'll go tell them and get them ready.
Do you want us sort of like almost there?
No. You guys will be early on. Yeah, you get to hopefully right about here when the splash happens.
Okay.
All right? So this is like one of those real John Hughes moments.
Gotcha.
They're gonna get into like their moment, and that's when the skateboarders hit air and splash.
Okay, cool. I want to work in like an infant scene where I'm breastfeeding with my grill.
Up next on Not Another Making the Video, Marilyn Manson makes for a strange bedfellow.
Do I really need to explain what's going to happen here? It's not good, I'll tell you that much.
And leaves his mark on Not Another Teen Party.
Didn't know God was so sexy.
Cameras and action.
I thought the movie was really funny. I laughed out loud. It's good to see a movie like that that's R-rated and it's not politically correct. So I thought it was pretty smart for something that normally would be middle of the road. It makes fun of things that are middle of the road, so I like that a lot.
It is. Check the gate.
Right. Checking the gates!
The next scene I'm about to shoot, I'm looking for Marilyn. And they point to my room, and when I get to my bedroom door, it's locked and I can't get in. Meanwhile, he's inside with a bunch of bunnies that have come to life.
Do I really need to explain what's going to happen here? I think it's pretty obvious. Now, just for the record, this is my dirty idea.
Just for the record, the pink room, this is Manson's idea.
The thing that I found is very effective is when you get them in their bras, you get them to jump up and down on the bed. Then you really get the full effect.
Hey, what are you doing there?
It's getting all exciting. It's kind of like a bunny right here.
Slate in, bunnies freeze, and playback.
Now I know I've got to run away. I've got to get away. Don't really want it.
Met a girl on tour a long time ago and got me to come back to her house. And her parents were sleeping and stuff. And I remember she had her bed was covered in stuffed animals. And by this dirty person that, as myself, was doing really bad things to her, the animals were scattering here and there. And I thought it kind of went against God and nature, and I was proud of myself for that. So I just wanted to recreate that for the kids at home.
And cut. That was cool. That'll work.
I was confusing. I was scared and confused.